The average human being hosts tens of trillions of microbes in and on our bodies, most of which reside in our intestines. And depending on the person, 2 to 6 pounds of our entire weight could be purely microbial. That's a lot of roommates who aren't paying rent, if you ask me. But it turns out that these microbial passengers are both giving back to us and potentially sabotaging us. Scientists are calling this the gut-brain axis, and some have even named it your second brain. It turns out that the teeming and diverse community in our gut acts as a collective unit with a mind of its own. That's right, we're talking microbial mind control. For example, your bacteria may be making your food choices for you. Some bacteria love eating fiber, some love pure sugar or fat, and depending on your diet, you may be cultivating a gut population with a preference for one over the other. Whichever your second brain prefers, it's probably going to tell you what it wants, loudly, and then complain when you don't feed it. Cue that hangry feeling when you just really need a chocolate bar at 3 p.m. Your microbes do this to you by hijacking your neurotransmitters until you feed them what they want. And when you do, there's a wave of relief as those bacteria release their happy feelings into your system, making you feel happy too. This interaction between your cravings and your microbiome and how your brain registers all of this is really complex. So if you want to learn more, just let us know and we'll look into it. When your bacteria feel happy, you feel happy because bacteria, as it turns out, communicate with one another via neurotransmitter. The same kind of chemicals used in your regular brain, like serotonin, dopamine, cortisol, and GABA. These chemicals transmit messages from one neuron to another in your brain, and because you host so many bacteria, when they use them, it can affect you and your mood too. The thing is, we're still unclear on how exactly these signals get from your gut to your brain. A likely candidate seems to be the vagus nerve, a really long nerve that connects your stomach and your intestines to the base of your brain, but it could also be your immune system or your endocrine system, or maybe it's all of them. But the results coming in from this kind of research are pretty remarkable. One research group at University College Cork in Ireland fed Lactobacillus rhamnosus, a good bacteria or a probiotic you can usually find in yogurt, to one of two groups of mice. The probiotic mice were much more likely to persevere and succeed in the face of adversity tests than those not treated with the probiotic. They repeated a similar study in humans, with the probiotic-fed humans displaying improved resilience to negative emotions than those without the probiotic. Some scientists hypothesize that the root evolutionary cause of this may be that your bacteria's ultimate goal is to spread. So when we cultivate a healthy gut population, the signals they're sending to our brain are encouraging us to be happy and social and go out in search of food so that we introduce them to more hosts. So by shaking each other's hand or kissing other people, we're picking up other people's bacteria and spreading our personal microbiomes, with all the benefits and drawbacks that entails, which is terrifying. There's all kinds of crazy ways that the bugs living inside you are connected to your brain, and it's a burgeoning research field that has great potential for personalized medicine. Imagine your doctor sampling your microbiota and knowing exactly which bacteria were sending you what signals, and then being able to modify your behavior, whether it be mood or diet related, by supplementing your gut environment with some new critters. Freaky. Want a healthy diet of science in your life? Then why not subscribe? And watch this video about how antibiotic-resistant bacteria have a new enemy in the CRISPR pill. Yeah, it's cool. Did you know that fecal transplants could potentially be life-saving? A transplant of a healthy donor's stool could save someone suffering from a fatal gut infection. The power of poop! Thanks for watching.